As the Israel-Hamas war continues to sow discord between so many people, we like to take opportunities to shed light on some special organizations that are doing the opposite, connecting people from differing faiths and backgrounds to help in the region. Joining me now is Joshua Waller and John Plocher to talk more about High Yovel, their organization that's doing just that. Gentlemen, thank you for your time and for the work that you're doing. Joshua, let me start with you. Tell us about High Yovel and who you're helping.
Sure. Yeah, we've been here. I'm the director of operations for the work. We've been here for about 20 years serving the farms in this region. And boy, this we never expected. October 7th came around and we were asked by the local authorities in our region here to help. So we've been helping, one, on the farm front, and two, bringing in supplies. The guys are in much, much needed. The communities around here are at massive need of supplies being brought in. So we've been, John and I and the team, we've been bringing in, volunteering on those farms and also bringing in supplies, bulletproof vests, helmets, night vision, all this kind of help. The two sound kind of funny together, but really this is what we need. We need the Jewish people protected, and we're doing everything we can to see that happen.
Right, and that's protecting their livelihoods. John, talk about some of the specific places where you all are doing your work, some of the communities in greatest need.
Well, we're here in Harbor Ka. We've been putting in some security roads around here. We've also been doing a lot of work down in the Jordan Valley, but specifically out in Judea and Samaria. That's where we're based out of. We did go down south for one day here this last week to help out with the farm down there, that some greenhouses where there was actually a rocket had landed in one of the greenhouses.
Josh,
but primarily,
sorry, go ahead.
We're out here in the west, in Judea and Samaria.
Are you having a tough time getting supplies into the region, Joshua? What are some of the challenges in an active war to do the work and continue some of your aid?
Sure. Well, when the war first broke out, immediately the shelves here in Israel just went totally empty. And so everything that's coming in is coming into the country from abroad. So thank God we've just gotten our first shipments in of supplies actually from the States. We're continuing those efforts. First pallets arrived. Hopefully by the end of the week, we'll have about 14 pallets of supplies arriving here. And Lord willing, that'll only increase as funds come in through the Operation Itai, through the work of High Yovel. We'll have a lot more pallets arriving soon.
Joshua, what are the things that people are farming there right now?
We've been helping. We never expected to be on a date. You know, some of the guys are like, is that a date tree or banana? But, you know, we don't have a lot of this kind of experience, but we've harvested dates. We've harvested peppers, zucchinis. So that's a lot of the harvesting that's going on. But we've also, you know, we're putting in fences. We're doing whatever the biggest need is, whatever that, you know, it could be a whole host of different things, whatever the need is that we're there to help.
Yeah. And John, talk about some of the volunteers, their backgrounds, their experiences, you both included, that you bring to the table that offer unique ways to help.
Well, right now I came with a group of guys. I flew over with three other guys, two of which I've good friends with back home in Montana and one from Arkansas. The two of us have more of a construction type background. I mean, I grew up farming and ranching and all sorts of horse stuff and kind of a do-it-all. All the guys that are here are very hands-on. They know how to fix anything and do anything, you know, ranching, that kind of stuff. And so that's kind of a big thing and a need right now is we haven't been on one specific task. We're doing a lot of different things and picking up with all of the men off to war and joining the getting called up to draft. There's a lot of tasks. I mean, even some of the things we're doing fencing, building, you know, building stuff, welding, all sorts of things where it's just a kind of an all well-rounded guy needed. So that's kind of our backgrounds and what we're here doing.
I love it. And we're seeing some of the video of the people you're helping. You see a lot of kids involved as well. What's been the response when you show up in these communities, you offer a helping hand, and you're working alongside them, John?
Yeah, they're just, I mean, it's overwhelming to me to see how much it means to them. I never realized how alone the Jewish people felt until we've been, you know, I'm just coming to help and they're like, you know, almost in tears. I mean, some of them are physically in tears that we're here to help. They're like, we didn't know that people cared this much, that they would come and are, you know, a need, a greatest time is this, that they need us. And it's very a humbling experience to be able to come and have that type of an impact. I came expecting to just bless with my hands and not anybody really even notice. But it means a lot to them. The sense of strength we visited with some soldiers here, and they're just blown away by, you know, they're like, wow, thank you so much. You know, it means a lot to them to see the support.
Thank you for watching. Go to NewsNationNow.com to find NewsNation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.